Welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to be learning how to work on our PC settings. I told you initially I'm going to teach you how to work on your PC settings. How do you get your PC settings? You come down to your diagonal right part of the bottom of your desktop, and then you get this. Here you click on your settings. You have these dialogues of this application opened. Now you click on change PC settings. Automatically this comes up. Now you are having different levels of these PC settings. Remember when I was teaching you how to actually customize the picture of your screen? I told you how to do that and you saw different pictures we can make use of here. Okay, now here you can come here in this PC settings. Here I also told you how to change your account and others. Now, but there's something I did not actually teach you. In that user's account, you can also you have other signing options where you can actually change your password. Here, this is my current password. Next. Now I may just see I don't want any new password anymore. So I just press next and finish. Definitely the account is no more having any password. Do you get that now? But here I can still create the password for it. And then I can re-enter. But there's something unique about it. Now, what is unique about it is that you can create a pin code like that of phone, like that of ATM, just 4-digit code. Now, when you create a pin, you see now I've clicked on it and I want to create a pin. Now I can create a pin like that one you use for your ATM. So instead of making use of the password, you can use the ATM password, something like the 4-digit pin. Now, when that digit pin did not work, it's going to ask you to enter your account password. You see, that one of that pin is actually used for quick access. Instead of making use of your normal password, you just make use of your pin code. Like that one you use for your ATM card. Then automatically, it's going to, you see, to just log in immediately. So that is the difference. Do you get that now? So immediately you create your code. You can't create anything more than two. You see, what you just want is automatically it goes in. Okay, let me see. First, confirm your current password. The first thing you do is to confirm your current password. Then, now you can now create, okay, the username. Let me see. Let me create the password. I don't understand what it's trying to show me. It says first confirm your current password. That's your user account password. Good. So now this is where you create your PIN. A PIN is a quick, convenient way to sign into this PC by using just 4-digit code. So you just enter the pin. Then let me see. Good. So automatically it has been created. Are you seeing now? So here you can remove the pin and all that. So you know how to do it now, right? I taught you about your switching to a Microsoft account initially. So it shouldn't be a big deal when you see it anymore. And these are other accounts that have been created. Automatically you can from here create another account if you wish to. Are you seeing it now? Give it a username, give it a password and others. Do you get it? So that is for that one. And when you want to log into it, when you boot, you can do anything. Now, this is for personalization, which I've shown you. And this one is for the activation of your Windows. If your Windows is not activated, it's going to show it here. If it's activated, it will show it. Now, you said I should activate my Windows. If you want to activate it online, you need to connect to the internet or you can call us. So here we can actually call them, activate by phone, automatically, immediately you click it, it's going to show you other things. So that is actually a kind of technical experience. So if you need to activate it, you can call us if possible. So it's kind of looking for kind of modem inside your PC. Okay. Now there are other things we can do. You see, this is even an error it even showed. Alright, so let me go back to the application that I showed you just now. Good, so we are here again. So now let's go to the activation after the users that we did just now. The notification area. Now, remember I told you about apps. Show apps notification. Maybe you are having some kind of emails and others. Apps is going to give you some notification if possible. Remember that some of these apps automatically connect to the internet. Show apps, show notification from these apps. So automatically, if you have any notification, you know what notification is now. Example is when you are having your Windows Defender. The Windows Defender is acting as your antivirus. Also, any other one, maybe your mails and others, maybe something is malfunctioning, maybe it's not working at all. Automatically, you can tell it, I want you to put it off. I don't want to receive any notification from this antivirus anymore. So these are all applications. Do you get that now? Okay. Also, you can decide to just switch them off automatically. You see, show apps notification automatically, it has shut them down. So there's nothing you can do then. Or you can say show apps, show app notification on lock screen. Are you getting it now? So play app notification sounds. Do you get it? So these are very, very important. So I can decide to put it off myself. So if you discover that the notification is disturbing you, you already know what to actually do. So that is it. Now let's go to the search area. Now whenever you are searching anything type of piece, example is this. I want to search, I can say Prince. You see, now, do you want to search applications? Do you want to deactivate it from search applications? You can see now here we're having files. So you can see that we're having files here containing Prince. Do you get it now? So that's the difference. Now, let's go back. Good. So now we are here. Do you want to delete the history? Search history in Windows. You kind of store it before. So here we can decide to show the apps that I search, and it show the apps that I search for most often at the top on, or let Windows save my searches as future search suggestion. Are you getting it now? So it kind of give you a suggestion of what you actually want to search and others. So this thing, you always see them in play always. So I don't think they are that important, but if you discover that there is something you actually need to actually shut down or quick it, put it off, you can just come here about your apps, just come and check the notification and your search. Then sharing actually how to do it. Share as you show the apps that I use most often at the top of the app. Share has to do with kind of communicating in a kind of community and others. So whenever you are connected to the internet, you have the ability to share files and others, maybe through wireless connection and others. So and mainly these are the applications that actually working with sharing presently. We have the SkyDrive, we have the people which has to do it, a kind of internet community, and we have a kind of social network, and also we have the mail. Do you get it now? So these are where you set it, item in list, five, clear list and others. So you can decide to clear the list if you wish to, and you can see it's done. So that is what it is. So you can show the list I share most often on. So these are actually internet based. Now the general here, you can also decide to set the time if you wish to. So remember I told you about time zone and others. So here you can come and choose the one you wish to set. So if you discover some of them, you can have Lagos there and any other thing. So you can see, you can come and choose any one of your choice. Application switching, allow switching between recent apps when I swipe from. So these are just main English words. Available storage, so here is going to give you general information about what are happening inside your PC. This one about available storage kind of give you This is the space of your hard drive and others. Also, refresh your PC without affecting your files. So, if your PC is not running well, you can refresh it without losing your... So, this actually you have to do with the technical aspect of your PC. Now, what this actually is, if you actually want to get this particular information on how to actually repair your computer yourself, you can actually get us informed about that so that we can send you a DVD concerning that. This is actually a technical aspect of your Windows 8. Now, the Windows 8 it has been done in a way that the computer can repair itself even far, far better than Windows 7, where you can actually repair your PC on your own. Actually, we have what we call the EFI. So this Windows is actually extended, and you need a technical experience to actually do this. Actually, moreover, you can actually do this yourself. Do you get it now? But it is not actually in this, it's not actually the content of this particular tutorial. So I kind of teach you what it actually entails. So you can see it, read it yourself, and you see what it's all about. But most time, for now, we are not able to give this tutorial because we don't have the virtual machine to actually teach this, except we have to use a manual camera to do that. So that is why there's a delay in doing this for now. So you can contact us to actually help you to know when you can get that if you wish to have it. Now, the privacy. Let apps use my location. So actually, for this privacy, you already know that privacy actually has to do with your own privacy. So sometimes you have to switch this off so that apps will not kind of know where you're actually coming from and others. Let apps use my name and account picture. Just imagine what that is. So you can actually decide to shut them down and others. So you can decide to check your privacy statement and others. So this actually is actually online, so I can close this, which actually I don't need it. Now let's go to devices. Now devices has to do it. All the devices that have been connected to your computer, the hardware connected to your computer, maybe through wireless, maybe through cable and others. So here it's going to give a list of what has been connected. We have some kind of virtual devices, we have virtual CD-ROMs, we have phones, maybe PC connected through wireless connection like your Bluetooth and others. You see, these are all types of files. Some of them virtual printers, some of them we have standard as virtual printers, we have some CDs and so many, even telephone. So depends on what is connected. Here we have the wireless devices. Here you can decide to switch off your wireless device. Here you can decide to turn it on. So if you're actually on flight mode, you can actually put this on, off, or on. This actually you can do it by switching it off. The reason why you have to switch it off is because maybe you don't want any disturb, you don't want to be connected at all, you just want to switch it off automatically. So your computer would have to do that itself. You have to come and put it on anytime by yourself. Do you get it now? So that's what you do. So the wireless devices, you can actually put it on or off on your own. Do you get it now? So this wireless has to do with maybe if your PC is Bluetooth compatible or wireless connection, maybe Wi-Fi and all that. So you can actually do that yourself. So that is what it's all about. Remember, wireless connection, make use of Bluetooth and your Wi-Fi. We'll go into that later. Then the ease of access. Actually, this way you kind of customize your PC to start talking whenever you point to and all that. Yeah, you can give a high contrast, maybe for an old man or an old woman, to actually tell them what to actually do, maybe kind of point to it. It can actually can be used by the blind and others. So depending on what you want to do, so it's possible that the PCs can be used by the blind people, but you have to set it to a particular configuration. That is why Microsoft has actually made this available for everybody to work with. So you may not need this anyway, but if you want to know more about that, go to Microsoft site and know more about how to do that. Then synchronize your settings. Now to change these settings, select users and switch to Microsoft account. Now this actually has to do with synchronizing the settings of your PC online so that actually you can still get them back. How to actually do this are very, very simple, but you need to have a Microsoft account to do this. So more about synchronization, we have a particular seminar we are actually taking on synchronization of your data, which is actually very, very important. But meanwhile, maybe when we go into the internet aspect of this, we may actually run back to this and actually teach you more about that. But for now, it's not actually available for now. Good. That the home group, this actually has to do with a network, a home network that you connect, that you know that is very, very safe. So this one, actually, you have to connect PC to PC. Actually has to do with network sharing and others. So it's not actually in the content of this, but maybe we can actually browse through this later. Then Windows updates. Now, whenever you are connected to the internet, you can decide to check for updates. And these are what your PC settings entails. Right? So I've actually given you a basic description of what they actually do, not all practicals have been done. So please note that, you know, we can't actually teach everything, but actually if we give you the description of what these things actually are, I believe you can do them on your own, right? Alright, so I believe you got what everything I have said, and now I want to switch to my desktop, and then let's take another topic. Thank you.